Today I will discuss analysis of trusses. A typical paired truss, as shown in figure, a truss structure consists of only two forces. A typical plane truss is shown in figure. A truss structure consists of only of two force members. This is every truss element is in direct tension or compression. This is every truss element is in direct tension or compression. It is required that all loads and reactions are applied only at the joints and all that members are connected together, ends by frictionless pin joints. So this is the truss element. So this is the joint, two forces, X direction force and Y direction force. It joints is frictionless joints. A typical plane truss is shown in figure. A truss structure consists of only two force members, X direction force and Y direction force. This is every truss element is in direct tension or compression. It is required that all loads and reactions are applied only at the joints, these joints, and that all members are connected together at their ends by frictionless pin joints. These are the pin joints. So two dimensional stress and two force members, this direction and this direction force. Next one is plane stress. The local and coordinate system. A typical plane truss element is shown in figure. Local and global coordinates. This is the truss element. Here, the truss element. The direction is Q1 displacement and the direction is Q2, Q3 and Q4. Here, for x direction, Q of 2i minus 1. Y direction is 2i. For example, I is equal to 1, 2 in 2 minus 1, Q1, and 2 into 1, 2, Q2. Suppose, for example, I is equal to 2, 2, 4 minus 1, Q3, and 2 into 2, 4, for second node. For third node, I is equal to 3, 2 into 3, 6 minus 1, 5, 2 into 3, 6, third displacement, Q5 and Q6. For fourth node, I is equal to 4, Q of 2 into 4 minus 1, Q7, Y direction is 2 into 4, Q8. For fifth node, I is equal to 5, 2 into 5, 10 minus 1, 9, Q9, and 2 into 5, Q10. Similarly, Q6, Q7, Q8. Here, the truss element, this is the truss element, the displacements is Q1 and Q2, and second node Q3 and Q4. The deformed element. Suppose this angle is theta, here up to distance is Q1 cos theta and Q2 sin theta. Here is similarly Q3 cos theta, Q3 cos theta, and Q4 sin theta. A plane truss, local and global coordinate system. A typical plane truss element is shown in figure. Local and global coordinate systems is shown in figure. So this one is local coordinate system and this one is global coordinate system. So this is the element, this is the deformed element. The displacement is Q1, x direction, y direction displacement is Q2, angle is theta. Its angle is theta. So up to this distance is Q1 dash, here is Q2 dash. Q1 dash is equal to Q1 cos theta plus Q2 sin theta, and Q2 dash is equal to Q3 cos theta plus Q4 sin theta. The local numbering scheme. The two nodes of the element are numbered 1 and 2. The local coordinate system consists of x dash axis which runs along the element from the node 1 towards to node 2. The local numbering scheme, the two nodes of the element are numbered 1 and 2. The local coordinate system consists of x axis which runs along the element from node 1 towards node 2. All quantities in the local coordinate system will be denoted by prime dash. All quantities in the local coordinate system will be denoted by prime means dash. All quantities in local coordinate system will be denoted by prime dash. The global x y coordinate system is fixed and does not depend upon orientation of the element. The global x y coordinate system is fixed and does not depend on the orientation of the element. The global x y coordinate system is fixed and does not depend on the orientation of the element. The global coordinate system, every node has 2 degrees of freedom. A node whose global node number is j as associated with the degree of freedom 2j minus 1 x-axis and 2j y-axis. The global coordinate system, every node has 2 degrees of freedom. A node whose global node number is j as associated with degree of freedom 2j minus 1 and 2j. The global displacement associated with node j are 2j minus 1 and 2j. Let q dash and q1 dash and q2 dash be the displacements of node 1 and 2 respectively. The element displacement vector in the local coordinate system denoted by q dash is equal to q1 dash and q2 dash whole power transpose. The element displacement vector in global coordinate system is 4 by 1 vector denoted by q is equal to q1, q2, q3, q4. The relation between q1 dash, q dash and q is developed as follows. Q1 dash is equal to q1 cos theta plus q2 sin theta, and similarly q2 dash is equal to q3 cos theta plus q4 sin theta. At the solid state, the direction cosines L and M are introduced as L is equal to cos theta and M is equal to cos phi and that equal to sin theta. All the stages of the direction of cosines L and M are introduced as L is equal to cos theta and M is equal to cos phi that is equal to sin theta. Therefore, Q dash is equal to LQ where the transformation matrix L is given by LM 0 and 0, 0, 0, LM. The element displacement vector in the global coordinate system is 4 by 1 vector denoted by Q is equal to Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 all power transpose. The relationship between q dash and q is developed as follows. Q1 dash is equal to q1 cos theta plus q2 sin theta. Q2 dash is equal to q3 cos theta plus q4 sin theta. At this stage, the direction cosines L and M are introduced as L is equal to cos theta and M is equal to cos phi that equal to sin theta. Therefore, Q dash is equal to LQ, where the transformation matrix L is given by L is equal to LM 0, 0, 0, 0, LM. Next, formulas for calculating small l and M. This is the element. First point x1 y1 and second point is x2 y2. So length of the element here This distance is x2 minus x1, here is y2 minus y1. The simple formulas for now is given calculating the direction of cosines from nodal coordinate data. So this is the length of the element, x1, y1 first point, second point is x2, y2. This length is x2 minus x1, y2 minus 1. Suppose sine theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side, opposite side by hypotenuse, opposite side is y2 minus y1 by LA. Cos theta is equal to x2 minus x1 by LA. RM is equal to cos theta, sin theta is equal to y2 minus y1 by LA. So in this diagram, sin theta is equal to y2 minus y1 by LA and cos theta is equal to x2 minus x1 by LA. And length of the element is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Therefore, L is equal to x2 minus x1 by LE, M is equal to y2 minus y1 by LE. The formulas for calculating small m and n, m. So, this is the diagram. So, length of the element. Element length is LE, node is first node and second node. The coordinate points x1, y1 and x2, y2. Here, distance is y2 minus y1 and x2 minus x1. Simple formulas are now given for calculating the direction cosines L and EM from nodal coordinate data. Let x1, y1 and x2, y2 be the coordinates of nodes 1 and 2 respectively. Let L is equal to L and E. L is equal to cos theta, that equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse, x2 minus x1 by LE. And similarly, M is equal to cos phi, that equal to y2 minus y1 by that equal to sin theta. So, length of the element LE is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square.